Hello everybody, welcome to the draw for example section. In this section, I'm going to draw some staircases. First, I would give the number of steps and the step width. And then I will use these two pieces of information to draw some steps using for loops. For example, when I want to have 5 steps and for each step, the width is 3, I would have this pattern. So each step is having a width of 3, so I use 3 stars to represent the width of 3. And for the second step, we would have the width of 3. And same for the third step, fourth step, and the fifth step. Okay, let's do the implementation. So I would like to set 2 variables to represent the number of steps and the step width. So I would like to reproduce the staircase at the beginning. I need 5 steps, and for each step the width is 3. So how can I use a for loop to do that? I can do something like this. Okay, I would do the for loop for the number of times indicated by lump steps variable. Since a lump step is 5, the iteration would start with 0, and then the iteration would go with 1, 2, 3, and 4, such that this condition always holds. If num steps becomes 5 after the addition done here, the iteration would stop because the condition in the middle is violated. So in this for loop, which is controlled by the number of steps, I can really draw the correct number of stars on each step. So I can do something like this to draw one row as one step. What does it mean here? J is a variable to control the number of stars to draw on each row. And the value of J can be at less than this value, which is indicated by the product of the step with together with the current step index. So I plus I would be the step number. Since for my case here, I start with 0. If I want to have the first row with stars, I would need I plus 1 to make it 1. And then 1 times step width would be equal to 3. So the first row would become 3 stars. Okay, since I need to draw 3 stars on the row, I use system.out.print instead of print line. If I use print line, every star would be drawn on a new line. Okay, so for the next step, I would become 1. So 1 plus 1 would become 2. 2 times 3 would become 6, so the second step would be having 6 stars. So when will we end this inner for loop? It ends when the loop control variable j is equal to I plus 1 times step width. Okay, what does it mean by here? If step width is 3 and num step becomes 4. 4 plus 1 is 5. 5 plus 5 times step width is 15. So the largest number of stars on the bottom row would be equal to 15. So we would be able to reproduce the staircase pattern at the beginning. So when j becomes 16, this one is no longer held again. After we have printed one row, we have to change to another row. So I need to do the changing here. So I use system.out.println to show that a new line is created. So after we have printed out the correct number of stars for one row, we change to another row, and then we do the printing of stars for the second row, so on and so forth, until we have finished all the number of steps required. So let us save it and see the result. Okay. Now we have 3 stars on the first row, 6 stars on the second row, so on and so forth. And we can see that for each step, the width is 3. Okay. So this completes the drawing of staircases. My code is intuitive and straightforward. However, it may not be the best solution or the most efficient version. If you can suggest any idea to improve my code, feel free to show your improvement on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.